Students, we are already done the topic of friction and different definitions associated with it. Today we will move next related to friction in our daily life. So before starting the topic, we will solve an MCQ, and the MCQ statement says that wheel is that object it dash as it moves. Four options are given to you. First is A, that is slide, B, roll, C, translate, and D, both B and C. Students, if you see the diagram, in the diagram on the right side is a driving force and on the left side is a frictional force. So driving force will move the wheel in a straight line, it means wheel will translate, and around the axis the wheel will have a rotatory motion, so it means it rolls as well. So right option is both B and C. A factual concept you need to remember it, that whenever a wheel is moving, wheel is having two types of motion. One is in a straight line and other is rotatory motion, that is rolls around its axis. A question is given next to this. It's a concept cascaded with friction. Why wheel offers very less friction when it moves? So today we will learn about this concept, that wheel is a very good invention of human beings, that it offers very less friction. That's why we are using wheels in trains, vehicles, transport system. Wheels is using because wheel offers very less resistance, it saves most of the energy. So question is, why wheel offers very less friction when it moves? Answer is, first of all, we will understand in the answer the scenario that the forward force is called applied driving force and opposite force act as the point of contact, that is called frictional force. In the end we will give the reason to this. So answer says that when the axle of a wheel is pushed by driving force, that is applied force, the force of friction between the wheel and the ground at the point of the contact provides reaction force. You can see that frictional force is providing reaction force in opposite direction to the driving force. This is what scenario is about. After full stop, the reaction force acts at the points of the wheel in the direction opposite to the applied force. So here the contact points and frictional force is acting opposite to this. Full stop. You will write the next statement with blue marker and underline it. The wheel rolls without rupturing the cold weld. If something will not rupture the cold weld means interlocking. If they will not rupture it, if rupturing sound you hear when the car is going to drift. So if the wheels will not rupture the cold weld, that's why the rolling friction is extremely small than sliding friction. If you make something such that it is not rupturing the cold weld, it means you have reduced friction many times. So sliding friction is more than rolling friction. So this concept can also be understand this way. So you have to write this with blue marker and the answer is given to you. Write it on your notebook and complete your notebook. Maintain your notebook. Write each and every question being discussed in this lecture. So next question is, you can see the diagram. From the diagram you can understand the question, why it is dangerous to drive on a wet road. So it is dangerous to drive on a wet road because the friction between the road and the tire is very small, because wet surface act like a lubricant. This lubricant reduces the friction and interlocking and cold welds between the two surfaces. This increases the chance of slipping the tires from the road. So if there is wet road, there is a greater chance for slipping the tires from the road. That is, one surface will slip over the other surface if one of the surfaces wet. So write the answer in your notebook as well as question with blue marker. Next question is, what is the purpose of threading on the tires? For example, if our car, we are going to Mari or Sawat or any hilly area, the road is wet and our car is going to slip. So to avoid this, we will use a tire with greater threading. So I have mentioned two diagrams. In one diagram, the ideal wheel which is having greater threading, and the next is the wheel being used and the threading is less. So there is a danger of accident because of slipping. So question says that what is the purpose of threading on tires? Answer is, the threading on tires is designed to increase friction. Thus the threading improves road grip. This is very important. Also write it with blue marker. Threading improves road grip and make it safer to drive even on a wet road. So threading will provide artificial interlocking of wheel with the road, and it offers greater friction so that the brakes are easily applied and the car can easily move and having good road grip. So write it in your answer with blue marker. You have to write the question. And if you are interested in drawing the diagram and having spare time, you can draw the diagram of the wheel with threading as well. Last question for today. How sliding helps a wheel to stop on a road while applying brakes? So sliding, how sliding is going to help? Because rolling is help in moving a car or a bicycle or a vehicle. Then how we can stop a bicycle or a cyclist going to stop his or her bicycle? Guys, whenever brakes are applied, the rolling friction will be replaced by sliding friction because the tires were interlocked with the brake, and when they are interlocked, it is a situation of drifting. So answer is, a cyclist apply brakes to stop his or her bicycle. We already know this. Full stop. As soon as brakes are applied, when he or she is going to apply the brakes, the wheels stop rolling and begin to slide over the road. So the wheels will stop rolling and they will be locked up with the brakes and they slide over the road. Since sliding friction is much greater than rolling friction, write it with blue marker. Since sliding friction is much greater than rolling friction, full stop, therefore the cycle stops very quickly. So whenever you are applying brakes, the tires are going to stop for a moment. This stopping moment will convert rolling friction into a sliding friction. Sliding friction is much greater than rolling friction, therefore the object will stop. Even it's a bicycle, it's a car or an aeroplane. So guys, write these short question, writing question with blue marker and answer with blue pointer. You may draw a diagram which you think suitable and easy to draw. Next, at the end I want to tell you that in the next lecture we will discuss about slipping when the road is wet and you are going to apply the brakes or car is moving with a greater speed. So what is slipping in locomotive of vehicles? If you apply braking, what is skidding and drifting? So in next lecture we will discuss these are important questions. This may be asked in the board exam. Okay student, for the next lecture, take care and have a nice day. I will see you in the next class.